Good morning, students. Today we shall discuss about the sources of Telangana history. In the previous video, we shall discuss about the part of Telangana history. What is that? The archaeological sources. In previous video, we shall talk about the archaeological sources like material remains, monuments, numismatics, and coins. This type of archaeological sources are most useful to the study of our Telangana history and also most useful to the reconstruction of the Telangana history. So continuous, today we shall discuss about the second division of Telangana sources, that is literary sources. Literary sources are the most outstanding understanding of the Telangana history. It is most important and outstanding to the understanding of Telangana history and to the study of Telangana history. Okay, this is also, the literary sources also can be subdivided into two categories. One is native sources and the second one is foreign sources. First of all, we talk about native literary sources. Native means regional, Swadeshi, Adhara. So, in the part of native sources, it is also subdivided into two categories. One is religious sources and second one is secular sources. One is religious sources, second one is secular sources. First of all, we talk about religious sources. Religious sources are refers to the religious aspects. It is mostly refers to the religious conditions and the religious customs and traditions who follow the society, in particular religion. Mostly here I mentioned three types of religious textbooks are most useful to the study of our Telangana history. Includes, the first one is Buddhist texts. You know, Buddhism was established by Lord Gautama Buddha. Later it was most popular during the time of BC 6th century to AD 6th century. So it is extended not only our India but also throughout the world. In the part of India, the Buddhism also spread in the southern part of India, especially our Telangana region, during the time of BC 1st century to AD 4th century. So in that, a famous Buddhist monk are living in this Telangana region, especially our Nalgonda district near Nagarjuna Sagar, that is known as in those days Nandikonda or Sri Parvatam. He lived in that region. So he was a great poet and scholar. He wrote so many books about the scientific knowledge and also about the religious principles of Buddhism. So according to Acharya Nagarjuna's books, are most useful to the study of our Telangana history, especially the BC 1st century to AD 3rd century up to 3rd century. Total indicates total condition of the Buddhism in southern part of India. And next, Jainism. So Jainism was established by Vardhamana Mahavira according to scholars. So this is also most popular sometime in this region. It is also extended the southern part of India also. So in that, Pampa, a famous poet and scholar, he patronized by the Arikesari king, Vaimulavada Chalukya king. So they were also ruled some India's part of Telangana. So he wrote Adi Purana. According to Adi Purana, he mentioned the position of Jainism in Telangana region. You know, a most popular, a famous holy Jainism temples are located in Telangana region, especially in Nalgonda district. You know, the Pillarmal. Now it is located in Suryapeta district. Once upon a time, that is a most famous Jainism holy place. And Alir, now it is located in Yadadri Bhavanagiri district. That is Kolanupaka. Kolanupaka also one of the most pilgrim center of Jainism in Telangana region. So this type of sources are most useful to the study of the Telangana society, especially the people, religious conditions of the people, particularly contemporary period of contemporary region. Next, Hinduism or Hindu texts are also most useful to that study of our Telangana history, especially two types of religious branches are here mentioned. One is Vaishnavite and Shaivite. In Vaishnavite and Shaivite accounts are most useful to the study of medieval Telangana history. Why? Because these two religious texts are most existence during the time of medieval India and medieval Telangana. So who followed the Vaishnavite and Shaivism? Most of the popular poets and scholars, they were wrote so many accounts about the Vaishnavism and Shaivism. This type of books most useful to the religious conditions of Telangana period, particularly contemporary period. So this is religious accounts to the study of our Telangana history. And now talk about secular. Secular accounts are most useful to the study of a particular belonging, society and administration of this region. Here I mentioned three type of secular accounts are here. One is biographies, second one is parvanas, and third one is newspapers and journals. First of all, we talk about biographies. You know, what is biographies? Biographies are the life stories of the rulers and kingdoms. So here, so many rulers, who they were, the Telangana region ruled, they were patronized by so many poets and scholars. Who were patronized by the rulers, poets and scholars, they were wrote some texts, they were wrote some accounts to praise of their kings are rulers. That's why this type of books or icons. Most useful to the particular kingdom or particular king. Here I mentioned some type of books here. For example, Vikramarjuna Vision. This is written by Pamba. He was baptized by Arkesari II, who ruled over Telangana region for the center of Vimalawada, Chalukya. In this book, he wrote about the victories of Arkesari II. So that's why we can deduce about the what type of background history having to Vimalawada Chalukyans in the history of Telangana. And Pratap Rudra Yashobhushan. It is written by Vidyanatha. Who wrote Pratap Rudra Yashobhushan? Vidyanatha. Vidyanatha was stayed in the court of second Pratap Rudra, the ruler of Kakatiya Kingdom. He wrote to praise their king, ruler Pratap Rudra too. That is Pratap Rudra Yashobhushan. This book is totally indicative about the life story of second Pratap Rudra and also how can decline of Kakatiya Kingdom in southern part of Telangana. And Halas Gada Shakta Sati. Halas Gada Shakta Sati also a most famous life story of the Telangana history. This book tells about the history of Shatavahana kingdom or Shatavahana family. So, not only this, so many biographies are there. So, further we can see in further years. So, this type of biographies are most useful to the study of particular king and kingdom. Second, Farmanas. Farmanas are the royal degrees of your Kutubushahis and Asabjai rulers in the medieval Telangana history. So, Farmanas are nothing but the monarchical account of the Kutubushahis rulers and Asabjai rulers. Total medieval Telangana history is occupied by these two types of families. They were ruled nearly 60 years in the history of Telangana. They were ordered so many monarchical orders, the purpose of administration, implementation in this region. So this is also most useful to the study of Kutubushahi rulers and Asabjai rulers. Not only Farmanas indicate about the administration, but also this Farmanas mentioned about the social, economic, religious conditions of the contemporary period. And third one, newspapers and journals. Newspapers and journals are also most useful to the study of modern Telangana history. Total modern Telangana histories depend on the information of newspapers and journals. Already you know, newspapers and journals are most played a key role in the social reformation in our society, Indian society, and also Telangana society. So in modern Telangana, so many newspapers and journals are established by there, so many scholars. Here I mentioned some three or four examples here. One is the Golconda and the Hindu and the Riot. This type of newspapers are published. So many ask questions sectors and discuss about the society, economy, and the religious aspects in contemporary period. And newspaper journals also motivated to the awareness of the people. So, and newspapers journals also indicate about the defense of the administration of the this type of information most useful to the study of particular Assam Jai administration and modern Telangana history. So this is the information about the native literary sources of the Telangana history. And now we talk about foreign literary sources. Foreign literary sources are also most useful to the study of our Telangana history and also the reconstruction of the Telangana history. Here I mentioned three types of foreign accounts or textbooks are most useful to the study of our Telangana history. First one is Greek sources. In ancient Telangana history, we can found a unknown writer account, that is the Periplus of Erythraean Sea. It is mentioned the ancient Telangana history. And Megasthenes Indica also mentioned about the Shatavahana rulers of our Telangana history. So this type of Greek books are most useful to the study of our ancient Telangana history. And the Italian sources. You know, one of the most Italian traveler and merchant trader, that is Marco Polo, he visited Telangana region and he wrote a famous textbook, that is the Travels. In that book he mentioned about the administration system of Kakatiyas, especially he focused on the administration of Rani Rudramadevi. And also he mentioned about the economic conditions of Kakatiya kingdom. So it is most useful to the study of Kakatiya administration and Kakatiya's family background. And finally, Arab and Persian sources also most useful to the study of our Telangana history. Mostly 6 or 7 decades are our Telangana region ruled by Muslim rulers like Qutbi Shahis and Asad Jais. They were belonging to the Muslim sects and they were encouraged Arab and Persian poets and scholars. During the period of Qutbi Shahis and Asad Jais, so many Persian poets and scholars write so many textbooks and accounts. This type of books and accounts are most useful to the study of Qutbi Shahis family and Asad Jais dynasty. So this type of foreign accounts are most useful to the comparison with our native literary sources of Telangana history. So this is information about the sources of Telangana history. And tomorrow we shall discuss about the Asmaka Janapada. What is Asmaka? And what is the importance of Asmaka Janapada in the history of Telangana? You can see in next video.